Have you ever tried to create a mockup in Illustrator and went into the menu and then this? Or maybe you actually managed to create the mockup, but then the objects were gone or didn't behave as you expected. Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at the things that can go wrong. So just to clear this first thing, this object here, as you see up there, is a raster image. It has a resolution, and the mockup in Illustrator only works when the top object is a vector object. But even then, things can go wrong. I've got something here just to show you something that is actually working. This is a live paint group, and let's select the bottom artwork, and then we can go to Object, Mockup, Create Mockup, and then Illustrator analyzes this, and then it will create that mockup. There we are, and Illustrator has mapped that mockup onto the bottle. It has also opened that panel. Let's close this. I'm going to undo this. So let's take a look at another one. This one here, the same object, but it has a shadow. So let's select them both and let's take a look at mockup. We can create the mockup, but then the shadow is gone when Illustrator has mapped this and this gray box appears. That tells us that some things cannot be made into a mockup. And this affects the drop shadow. The drop shadow is a pixel-based effect, and if some pixels are inside that artwork, then those parts will vanish. If you have applied an effect that converts the whole thing into pixels, such as all the effects down here will do, then the artwork will be created, but you won't get something applied on the bottle. It will just vanish. Let's undo this. We've got something here, and let's create that mockup. And you see, it has partly worked, but something is gone, which is the background. The background wasn't a pixel image, but a freeform gradient, and that doesn't work either. So let's undo this. And let's take this, and let's go to the next things. So I'm going to use this image and let's put it onto the glass jars. Let's take these for that. I'm going to create another mockup. And you see, Illustrator has selected something where it can put it on. We can now move it to the side and you see it doesn't really work on that back bottle there. So Illustrator has really issues finding the bottle for that label to put on. So some images don't really work well or at all. So when Illustrator has issues finding that, there's really not a lot you can do about that. If those are not glass surfaces, but something that is white, then maybe you can increase the contrast in the image, but that's about it. Let's undo this as well, and let's take a look at the next one. So this is a carpet, and let's suppose we want to have that on the carpet as a print. And again, we're going to create the mockup. And this is the result. And you see, Illustrator could map it to the perspective of the carpet, but as we have already seen in the other results, so maybe you have compared what we did before to what you might be accustomed to when you use Photoshop mockup files, then this is somewhat not really impressive. You see, the shadow of this plant has no effect on the artwork. And also the texture has no effect. So this is not what Illustrator's mockup does. Illustrator's mockup picks up the perspective and adjusts the thing to the perspective, but it doesn't do lighting, it doesn't do texture, it just makes that deformation. So what we can do in this case, because this is white, we can open the transparency panel like this and set this to multiply. And then this looks more convincing. And in this case, it actually works quite well. But still, of course, this should have some more texture. This should have some little wavy spots along those lines, but that's not what Illustrator's mockup does. So let's undo that again. Going to undo a couple of steps. And let's take a look at the last one down there. So I'm just taking this and putting this on here. And let's create the last one. And you see, this goes completely wonky because of that sharp contrast. Illustrator finds some of that texture in there, but it actually finds too much texture in there and tries to map that artwork onto it so that we get something like an animation when moving this around. So again, this is something you cannot do a lot about. So these are some of the things that can go wrong when you apply a mockup in Illustrator.